Cheluva Narayana Swami Temple is located in Melkote, Karnataka. The place is also known as Tirunarayanapura. It is built on rocky hills known as Yadavagiri, overlooking the Kaveri Valley. The temple is a square building of large dimensions, but is very plain and only sparsely ornamented with carvings or sculptures. The presiding deity is Cheluva Narayana Swami, also known as Tirunarayana, a form of Lord Vishnu. It appears from inscriptions that in the early centuries after the temple was built, the Lord was also known by the name Ramapriya, but this usage has now completely disappeared. The Utsava Murthy, which is a metallic idol used for processions and certain religious rituals, represents the deity Cheluva Narayana Swami. According to a legend, this metallic image was once lost but was recovered by Sri Ramanujacharya. The annual report of the Mysore Archaeological Department states on the strength of epigraphic evidence that the presiding deity of this temple was already a well-known object of worship even before Sri Ramanujacharya worshipped at the shrine in December 1098 CE. And even before he came to the Mysore region, and that very probably he used his influence to rebuild or renovate the temple. From the lithic records of the period, existence of Tamil influence and Vaishnava worship in the area are also evident. The temple is richly endowed, having enjoyed the special patronage of the Rajas of Mysore. As early as 1614, King Raja Vodayar, who first acquired Srirangapatna and accepted the Sri Vaishnava Pontiff as his guru, handed over to the temple and to the Brahmins at Melkote the estate granted to him by Vijayanagar Emperor Venkatapati Raya. While that estate was lost when zamindari was abolished in the 1950s, the temple still possesses many properties and valuables, in particular an extremely valuable collection of jewels. On one of the pillars of Navaranga of the Narayana Swami temple is a bas relief about 1.5 feet high of Raja Vodayar standing with folded hands with his name inscribed on the base. He was said to have been a great devotee of the presiding deity and a frequent visitor to the temple. A gold crown set with precious jewels was presented by him to the temple. This crown is known as the Rajamudi, royal crown, a play on the name of Raja Vodayar, the donor. According to legend, King Raja Vodayar was observed entering the Sanctum Sanctorum of the Lord on the day of his death and was seen no more afterwards. From the inscriptions on some of the gold jewels and on gold and silver vessels in the temple, it is learned that they were presents from Krishnaraja Vodayar and his queens. Krishnaraja Vodayar also presented to the temple a crown set with precious jewels. It is known after him as Krishnaraja Mudi. The Vairamudi, diamond crown, another crown of great value, seems to be older than the Rajamudi and the Krishnaraja Mudi. However, it is not known who presented it to the temple. Before 1098 temple existing, but British rulers destroyed after 1098, Ramanujacharya recovered idol from Delhi ruler daughter Ammavaru, that idol at bottom of Cheluva Narayana Swami foot. Vairamudi, that is diamond crown, given to the temple by Sri Krishna, Balarama, Garud, Mantudu. All the three crowns are kept in the safe custody of the state government at the Mandya Treasury. They are brought to the temple to adorn the image of Cheluva Narayana Swami only during a specific annual festival known as Vairamudi Habba, Diamond Crown Festival. Om Namo Narayanaya.